Hello everyone and welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video future value formula, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today we have a topic that is future value formula, which is completely based on the financial modeling which comes under Excel. Well, we'll try and study this topic in a much more detailed format. So let's begin for now how exactly this works. Well, the future value formula is basically C0 into 1 plus R raised to N. Now, the future value is basically a financial terminology which is used to calculate the value of the cash flow at a futuristic date as compared to the original receipt. So the objective is to understand the future value of the prospective investment, whether the return yield is sufficient returns to factor in time value of money. The formula for the future value is, as we discussed, FV is equal to your C0 into bracket 1 plus R raised to N. C0 here is the cash flow at initial point. R is the rate of return, and N is the number of period. Let me take an example of FV formula to give you a much more detailed insight. Let's say there's a person called Mr. Smith who has $9,000 in her bank account, Miss Smith, and she earns an annual interest rate of 4.5% with the help of the future value formula. Her account after 15 years, okay, will be FV is equal to 9,000 into 1 plus 0.045 raised to 15. Okay. So how does that work? 9,000 into 1 plus, or just, I'll just remove the FV here. This will give you an answer of 17,417. As simple as that. Well, we can consider another example for better understanding. Let's say Ms. Smith has another account which has $20,000 for paying an annual rate at 11%. Compounded, let's say, on quarterly basis. Okay. Now, since January 2017, the terms of the agreements have been renewed and the compounded interest is attributed twice a month. Okay. Ms. Smith wants to compute the total value of the account on December 31st, 2017. So, we firstly need to arrive at the opening balance on January 2017. So, present value is equal to Jan 16 and December 16. That is 20,000. The compounding period N is equal to here 4 months. And the annual interest rate is 11%, which converts down to 2.75, 11 divided by 4. So, our FV will be around 20,000 into 1 plus the interest rate quarterly 0.0275 raised to 4. So now you have converted interest, you are compounding, you are not just directly converting, you have to reduce down the interest rate to the compounded interest rate and then you get back on the yearly one. So now this will give you an answer. Just remove the FV here because is equal to will be in formula, that will give you 2292.43. Which is, see, the compounding period now over here is, let's say, 2 into 24. Now, since the compounded interest now is twice a month, the annual interest rate is 11%, which converts the monthly interest rate as 11 divided by 12%. That is equal to 0.0092. This will further split twice in the month, that is 0.9 2 divided by 2. That will be 0.46. Right? So your FV, future value, will be, your future value is going to be your present value, which is your 2292, okay, into 1 plus 0.0046 raised to 24, which gives you 24,488. So after this, let me give you and make you understand what exactly is the use of the formula. First, the primary benefit of FV is to determine whether an investment opportunity will be gamer sufficient or not. Okay. Second, the concept is applicable to personal and corporate decision. Third, the objective here is to have the understanding on how the economic factor, okay, can have an impact on the earning, such as inflation, standard of living, operating expense, recurring expenses. Separate analysis is required to be done. Fourth, it shows the stream of payment, okay, which are expected to receive over the period of time, that is 10-year investment, can show, you know, how much return can be earned in an every year. Fifth, in certain circumstances, the formula is also used as in what we call as input to other formulas. For example, annuity in the formula for recurring deposits in an interest account will be FV of every deposit. So, well, let me show you the future value calculator. Now, if you put C0 as 10,000, R let's say 10%, and N as 12 months, that will turn up to 313,338. Okay, if N is 1, then so it will rise at 1%. So it will rise at 10% for 1 year, it will be 11,000. We change it to 2%, it will be compounded. So that's why it's 1210. Okay. And had it been 3 years, so I did for how much initially at 12 years. So that is why it is showing me 3138. It is compounded. Now, instead of that, if I just put over here N is equal to 4 and this as quarterly, see, it has been compounded. So the compound, this is the compounded rate of return, which is showing the higher future value. But if I just turn it on the yearly compounding, it will show me lesser amount. So higher the compounding, higher will be the amount. Lower the compounding, lower will be the future value formula. So let me change it to yearly over here. This is yearly. Now if I do it 6 monthly, so I'll need to convert this as half. See, it turns out to 1340. See, the compounding is going high. Okay, I've converted this to half. Well, this was how the whole has been calculated. The present value 9,000, interest was 4.5, future value is this. Then there's a change of the compounding period to quarterly. We have reduced down the quarterly interest rates, and then accordingly the amount got increased with the quarterly compounding. I hope after this topic you have got a fantastic idea regarding this particular area of future value. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you once again everyone for joining the session.